Hi there, my name is Marina Miletic. Here are some estimates for heat transfer coefficients based on the type of fluids being used, a range from highest to lowest value. Remember that the overall heat transfer coefficient can be calculated and is based on a number of factors, such as the phase of the streams, whether liquid or gas, the velocity of the stream going through the heat exchanger, the design, thickness, and shape of the heat exchanger, the materials of construction of the heat exchanger, among other factors. Remember that a high heat transfer coefficient value represents a heat exchanger which has the potential to transfer a lot of heat per unit area and per degree of temperature difference. A heat exchanger with a low heat transfer coefficient means that little heat will be transferred per unit area and per degree of temperature difference. So for heat exchangers with a low heat transfer coefficient, a larger area or a higher temperature driving force must be used. Reboilers are heat exchangers which create boiling and have a high heat transfer coefficient because of their physical design and because they usually involve both streams in the heat exchanger changing phase. So the hot stream will condense into a liquid and the cold stream will be brought to a boil. A steam liquid heat exchanger uses steam to heat up liquid. This results in a lower coefficient because there's most likely only one phase change occurring, namely the condensation of steam. A condenser is designed to condense vapor into liquid, and its heat transfer coefficient is similar to a steam liquid heat transfer coefficient because, again, there's only one phase change occurring, that of the vapor condensing, most likely on the surface of the tubes. We see a big drop between these types of heat exchangers which feature latent or phase change heat transfer and simple heat transfer heat exchangers when we move to a liquid heating up or cooling down another liquid. Here, no phase change is occurring. The heat transfer is simple, conductive, and convective. The range for coefficients is larger because the heat transfer is dependent on the velocity and type of fluids. When steam is used to heat up a gas, it condenses and transfers its heat. But since it's highly dependent on convection and not conduction, there's less heat transferred per unit area. Liquids heating up or cooling down gases have a range of coefficients, much like liquid-to-liquid transfer. Since liquid-to-gas is simple heat transfer with no phase change, its coefficient is lower than that of steam to gas. The lowest heat transfer coefficients are seen with gases heating up or cooling down other gases using simple heat. There's no phase change, so no latent heat, only convective heat transfer, which is a lot less effective than conductive per unit area. This means that a large heat exchanger will most likely need to be used for heat transfer between gases. Thanks for watching.